there, Leslie Kimiko here, creator of Your Classroom Dance Teacher, today with a quick tip on how you can use your kinesthetic intelligence to help you relax. So, say it's the end of a really long day and you're lying in bed but you can't get to sleep. You've got that hamster wheel of thoughts churning over and over in your brain. And now's a time when a lot of us would pull out our smartphones and start scrolling through Facebook or turn on the television and try and take our mind off of the thoughts of the day to help us get to sleep at night. Well, studies have shown that that blue light that emanates from your smartphones and from television screens is actually doing us a lot more harm than we originally thought. The short wavelengths of that blue light interrupts our circadian rhythms and impedes our body's ability to produce melatonin, that sleep-inducing hormone that helps us relax at the end of a long day. So what else can we do? Well, you're in luck, because your nervous system is a built-in tool that you can use to help yourself relax in those moments if you know how to use it. So what does that look like? First, let's get a quick idea of what our nervous system does. In perhaps an oversimplification, our nervous system's job is to collectively organize our coordination for how we think we're put together and the job that we want our bodies to do. In a description that I love from Robin Avalon of the Contemporary Alexander School, your nervous system is hardwired for tension at one end and sensation at the other. That means that whenever we want to undo excess tension in our bodies, we can simply ask our nervous system for more sensation, and our nervous system will go through and efficiently shut off all the switches of tension that we don't need in order that we might have a deeper sensory experience. Well, that's fascinating, but how's it going to help me get to sleep at night? Well, when you're lying in bed at night and you're experiencing tension either in your brain or in your body that's keeping you awake, you can tune into your nervous system by asking a few simple questions. Some that I find are easy for people to grasp are, what are the ambient sounds that I hear in the room? That might be as simple as laying in bed and listening for the refrigerator running or the traffic noise that might be outside your window. You can ask your body for some information about things that may be touching your skin. So for instance, without looking, can you feel where the covers are touching your body and where they're not? Where is your body touching the surface of the bed and where isn't it? So by asking yourself those kinds of questions and tuning into the answers, not by looking down and seeing that the covers come up to here on my arm, but can I tell without looking where those covers stop and start? Those are the kinds of things that are going to take that hamster off that wheel in your brain and give it somewhere to go. This simple activity may help save that desire for distraction that often sends us running for Instagram, but without the harmful blue light effects. All right, I hope that helps. This is Leslie Kimiko, creator of Your Classroom Dance Teacher, and be looking for a lot more of these tips and tricks coming your way real soon. If you have a request or a comment or a suggestion for another episode, you can write to me here at the address you see on the screen, yourclassroomdanceteacher@gmail.com, and I'll look forward to putting a video together just for you. All right, that's it for me today. Good luck getting to sleep tonight, everybody, and until next time, happy dancing! Anybody?